球的话，请讲者 Griffin 来帮我们讲 PM Light PU Navigating， 我们听 PM Navigating。
Why we need a delegate in sensor for that. That's because when you run computation intensive neural network, other mobile devices, it's quite resource pending, especially for those mobile CPU, because the processing power on the end is quite limited, and energy consumption is always a problem on mobile devices. And that's one thing, unfortunately, that's one thing that is useful. That matches the application, which is the basis of the convolution of the fully connected layer. It's highly parallel. It's quite easy to parallelize a matrix application. People know that from back from 1950 or 60s. Anyway, so on some devices, there are many middle-end or high-end devices in this kind. Good GPU or ESP or even accelerators that could be used to accelerate the neural network, or say, particularly that could be used to accelerate the matrix multiplication or matrix vector multiplication. That's how and why tensor for light is used. Okay. So I used the tensor light and computer in some collaboration set, and I saw there is a tensor for light GPU delegate before. It's about in the beginning of this year, I think. And there was just the manual releases, no source code available yet at that time. So I learned some. We get dirty GPU diagram for both Android and iOS devices. So when the source code came out, I want to know a little bit more about how the delegate the GPU diagram, especially the GPU diagram is done. So I gave it a little bit, so I think we can share a little bit. Okay. So before we go into going to any delegate, we have to learn some basic data structure. There are three important structures that are crucial. We have to know it a little bit, otherwise we cannot understand the data. Structure, there's a what is a PM9? In case you don't know it, it's an algorithm inference engine. It's originally designed for, or originally developed for Android or Android-like iPhone. And it's a, it was extended in micro controller, such as ARM, for instance, or RISC-V step. It's an interpreter device. And all the operations, OTs, are organized as a day, directing the signal graph. So how you execute the node in the deck, you just do, simply do topological solving, and execute it one by one. Basically how the peer library occurs in here. Okay. Then these three basic data structure, you cannot read this. You cannot read this. You probably can read this. It's just to show the peer library context. Peer library context come with some global data structure that is globally visible to component within the TFI context. So it includes look at all the cancers of the virus. So you can see all the cancers, the cancer size, and you can see the array of cancers. And there are many functions that they can access those data structure. That's the context. So basically, it's to include the all the tensors. And therefore, the node, or the OP, data structures that are very important. Actually, this in TensorFlow Lite, TF-Lite node and the TF-Lite registration are put into a pair of vectors. It's a vector of node and registration. And you check this slide, or say, you can, I put a link here. So that's why I put it is doable like everyone here. So there is not good, we can still continue on the top. And the node, the TF by the node, there's basically some attribute. You put output some immediate and temporary tensors with some user data. Of the building data and customer, etc. Well, not all of these are very important, but you just notice that here that contain most of the attributes, data. And the ball and OD, there's another, there are other kind of stuff that need to be prepared. So, for example, if A, OBE is combined, let's say, and then for initialization, then for the pair management, then it has to be the unit of the pair. And when it is invoked, the OBE invoke will call something like this. And to learn more about this three data structures, the best way I know is to create a custom OP. There are some attributes visible that already. Okay, so now we can go into a physical knowledge delicate. So in case you didn't notice that, it's kind of weird that TF-Lite is mainly written in C++, but this has C styles. It's short. It's short. Now the member function is used. This is C style callback. Yes, you cannot read this. Okay, these functions, this kind of member functions, both a member method, are actually C style function of the data structure. well, it's designed that way. So it's designed so you can, the C API and the C++ API can share the same code, share the same data structure. And the C API is easier for binary function interface. So the principle that I have is C API and the data objective C, small talk, not small, small talk is in my head. Sweep, again, the other kinds of binding that you use for C API are also possible. So this is what I say. And for the TM-Lite directly, it's relatively easy. So what you have to implement is to provide the data, set in the bag, and implement the compare. And when you prepare some memory management function like copy from other angle, but not all of these are required. Usually only okay. So, what the TMI directly, how does it work? How does it work? So, when you have, this is an example from the TMI application. So, say you have a to E and V, and then you have a delicate and then you can do these two basically pretty fast, and you can collect a delicate implement a delicate code, delicate and then you combine the expression function with such like this, so that in the graph it will be replaced with multi code and delicate, something like this. And for a real model, this is you cannot do this. This is the right hand V1 model. The first one is a general convolution, and that's what's convolution, complex convolution, that's what's convolution, that's what's convolution. 13 such that's what complex convolution, but it's radically. So either the NLP delegate or the GPU delegate or older node can get into delegate. So we see just one of the two. That's how delegate will work. So there are I know there are GPU delegate actually contains two ones, how to delegate them on Android GLS delegate. GLS computer based. On iOS device is Python based. And there is a black delegate that to provide a selective OP if the URL API cannot support accelerating. Accelerating OPU can use TensorFlow's eager mode to run those some selective applications. Why NLAPI delegate and GPU delegate? And the Flex delegate? Well, because NLAPI delegates, NLAPI started from Oreo. Maintenance release MR1. It's Android at 1. This is a data from background main this year. Main sentence this year. So even the coding is Google's data, so according to Google, there are about 25% and 26% of devices supported in the API. That does not mean all of them support the NMAP 9. It's a regular way. But, yeah, shouldn't support the NMAP 9. That's not a main. Okay. So, for OpenGL, yes. OpenGL, yes. With Computer Shader is background of the OpenGL ES 3.1. So when you start with OpenGL ES 1.1, that's about the same devices only. So GPU dedicated is supposed to be all available on more devices. So this is a kind of an overhead in the ES level. It's a C++. Okay. So, but the delegate is supposed to implement. So, as we see, it will replace some existing OE as an OP. So, it's an OP, so you have to have a peer value registration for the interview. So, that's why I spend time on peer value registration. And then for creating an instance, then you have to create an instance of peer value delegate. Then you can register delegate. It will suppress it like this. Okay, this is an NMAP delegate. How you implement the stuff. Okay, it's direct from peer value delegate. It has some private data structure, some extra memory function corresponding to private data structures. And there are some interesting data that can power performance trade-off and the accelerator name and the cache delivery. So, for NMAP stuff, so you have to compile from it's kind of translated or it's a compile from high level tier diagram into the level stuff. So, for example, if you are a GPU, you have to compile shader code. Either GL is shader code or OpenGL. Low level to use that, and the group probably will be caching, so there's a cache directly in that, so like this. So to, you can find how NMAP delegate registered command, and put some point in it. This is the interesting part about NMAP delegate kernel. The hint beneath the kernel is that if NMAP is larger than or equal than 1.2, it will check if there's any real NMAP. If there's no NMAP, we can so-called real accelerator, which means only CPU callback is there, only there is any CPU callback, then the GPU line will not delegate the execution to callback function, the CPU callback. It's like this. And there is also one interest code in there is also interesting conversion is to convert from INTA to assigned INTA. Why? Because originally, NMAP was designed to use a symmetrical assigned INTA. Because they didn't know if signed symmetric combination will work well or not at that time. So they study about a symmetric exciting to do that. But there are more individual and corporate. Yeah. It seems that symmetric organization also did well. So the peer value is switching to sign the individual and then and then there is inventory. It's kind of difficult to move as fast as tier value. So the MNPI delegator to convert to the conversion. And for the invoker is quite easy, just MNPI. The MNPI delegator just call MNPI to the tier. That's basically, I think I covered basically how the API manager run. And there is interesting stuff called the partition graph. So, before recent API change the GPU delegate, so the delegation is kind of run very messy. Which means in any one of the OP can kind of be mapped into the delegates OP, it will fail. Nothing will be done. But after the subgraph stuff is introduced, if the one of the OP is not subgraph, it will be go back to tier 9. So tier 9 will do the work. And that's the with how the partition graph does the job. Okay. And you can find I find a kind of a GLS delegated tier value search network in order part and then the GLS delegated part and then the maker part of the IRS all the stuff. Originally, I was planning to introduce or to study how the GPU delegate is designed. Kind of put it on the slide when I see the report. But unfortunately, they all say, unfortunately, Google guys bought a delivery to publish in less than a month. So, I think that you can find out how the design procedure and the design trial can be leveraged away. Okay, and that's the when is that where is Alex Bellicat? So I don't know what time. So I skip the HTML has a kind of delegate stuff in the beginning, but it's not a real delegate. And then it switched to a real delegate based stuff, and I used the demo input. Demo, I don't accept the demo. So that's my ambition. So HDD is a delegate now. It's a introducer of the this is the final style. So if you are interested in TensorFlow, either TensorFlow or TensorFlow Max, you still have many opportunity to improve your code. What I said is, this is one of the small things I said. It's actually takes the quite trivial problem. So originally, they intend to write else, but somehow else is known. Then something should only be executed if all the previous conditions fail. This is killed about bother every time. And then this is kind of error checking. So prior, it's kind of like a, this kind of animal rights operation should work most of the time, but you get an incorrect operation type of pets most of the time. This kind of bug actually happened in TensorFlow 9. So, yeah, the big simple equation just. I think it's just been 5 or 10 minutes. That's it. That's all.